بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وبه نستعين. Dear four year dental school faculty of dentistry, with you Dr. Amr Gab, assistant lecturer of oral medicine and the periodontology diagnosis and x-ray department. Today we will discuss with you oral medicine chart. This is the first page. Here we can see patient name. This is the ID for this chart. Each chart is identified by the patient name. About the age is very important for us because some diseases are linked to a young age and others are linked to old age. For example, acute herpetic gingival stomatitis. It is usually present in very young child from 1 year to 2 years. Also, old age may have a candidal infection. So the age is very important for us. Also, sex. Some diseases are linked to sex. For example, pregnancy tumor. It is linked to female only. No pregnancy tumor will be present in male. Other diseases as lupus erythematosus, it is present, it is 9 female to 1 male. So some diseases are linked to sex. For address, we here talk about some countries the disease are epidemic. For example, Egypt here, epidemic for virus C and virus B, and bilharziosis. So we should put on our mind, is the country, is this a disease, is it epidemic in area? We should put this disease in our mind when we diagnose our disease. The clue may be here. Occupation, for example, carpenter use pins in his mouth, and during work we may see a friction keratosis lesion may be present in his mouth. For temperature, high temperature, for example, coronavirus. Coronavirus is associated with increase in body temperature. For our oral medicine department and our oral disease, for example, acute herpetic gingival stomatitis, it is presented with increase in temperature. Herpangina is increase in temperature. Hand, foot, and mouth disease also increase in temperature. Some disease as axis ulcer, there is no increase in temperature. Other disease as pemphigus vulgaris, it's immunological disease, there is no increase in temperature. Although destruction orally and all over the body. Okay, also we should know the normal blood pressure. It is usually 120/80. And pulse rate is usually between 55 and 60 pulse. For chief complaint here, we usually take the patient same word. The patient may come and say, "Doctor, I have a burning sensation on a check." So I will write the substance as it is. May say, "I have exophytic lesion present in my heart palate." Also, I will write like this. For when we talk about history of chief complaint, it is important. You usually will talk about onset of this disease. The answer here may be from 1 week, from 2 months, from yesterday. Answer me, okay. Also, we should talk about the course of this disease. Is this disease is stable or it is increased in size? Also, we should talk about predisposing factor. Some patient may say that as lemon and orange juice may increase the pain in my check. Answer me. Also, we would ask the patient about what is relieving the pain. Patient may say, stop drinking lemon juice. Other may say, stop biting. Okay. When we talk about dental history, we should examine the patient carefully for all dental treatment he have made. For example, the patient may make a partial prosthesis, removable prosthesis, and they have a clasp. This clasp, it is not adjusted. So this glass maybe make a stretch on the gingiva. After that, I will find ulcer here, or maybe I found a friction keratosis may be present. The mucosa may make a protection for itself by adding a keratin layer. This is for example. So I should know what the patient may make at the dentist, so I can find the clue for the problem here. This about dental history. For example, the patient may had made amalgam filling. And amalgam filling in some patient may make a leukonoid reaction on check. If the patient make amalgam filling and after 1 week or 2 week, a white lesion appear on the check. So it may be a leukonoid reaction as a differential diagnosis. So we should remove this amalgam and the lesion may be disappear. For the past dental history here, we talk about date of last visit. Ask the patient about date of last visit and the server rendered, as the server may be the clue for the problem. Answer me? Okay. Now we will talk about medical history. I will give you example for the medical history. You should know the importance of medical history. You have a ligature called medically compromised patient. This is the most important ligature in diagnosis. It's important for your life as a dentist, for your life at clinic. For example, heart disease. Patient positive for heart disease. It is very important. Why it is very important? Because you should know that patient with heart disease may or usually have a prosthetic valve, usually take antiplatelet, usually take anticoagulant. So the patient is as high risk for bleeding. So if this patient is heart disease and you will take a biopsy, you should make a consultation for this patient with his physician to know, can I make my biopsy? Can I make a scanning? Can I make a dental extraction here? Also should know that this patient is at danger for subacute bacterial endocarditis. Should know that microorganism may pass with your bloodstream and go to the valve and make a subacute bacterial endocarditis. This patient usually have antibiotic coverage before and after the treatment and during the treatment. Also, we will talk about liver disease. Here we fear from two main things. First is infection. I fear here from infection. Infection for my, I should protect myself. I should double gloves, double mask. Also, this patient is at risk for bleeding, because usually the liver have dysfunction or decrease in its this liver is ill. So usually there is a problem in make a coagulation factor as factor 10, 9, 7, and 2. So this patient usually at high risk of bleeding. So if I know this patient is a liver disease, I put in mind this patient has a high risk for bleeding, and I usually ask for bleeding lab investigation. Also, diabetic patient, usually we fear about diabetic patient to go to coma. This is a hypoglycemic coma and a hyperglycemic coma. I fear the patient is sitting in my chair and maybe it is uncontrolled diabetes, it may go to coma. Also, I usually fear about this patient have a delayed wound healing. Usually, I make my appointment very fast. Usually, I divided my work on patient powers in more than one session. If the patient is diabetic for oral disease, some disease may be associated with diabetes, as lichen planus. Some diabetic patient may have a lichen planus. It's called a Greenspan syndrome, diabetes and hypertension, and oral lichen planus. Also, usually diabetic patient may have a candida infection. Understand me? So, you take a clear and careful dental and medical history, maybe the clue for your oral medicine problem. Also, for a pregnant woman, some disease always may be associated with pregnant woman as a pregnancy tumor. It is usually appear in patient have a low blood control or not make a good blood control, maybe have a pregnancy tumor. Also, we should know that pregnant women usually work at the safe time for it. It is usually the mid trimester, fourth and fifth and sixth months. Usually, we didn't work at the first and second and third trimester. We usually fear about abortion. And the last trimester, we usually fear about early delivery. Okay, also, we should, if the patient is pregnant, you should put in mind the patient may go to coma. So usually the patient is sitting in your chair and his lower shoulder is at low position and right shoulder at a high position. Okay, to avoid coma. Okay, put in your mind, as example, the patient may take other medication. You should know that there is a hypertensive, antihypertensive medication may make oral like implants. Understand me? So, if the patient take antihypertensive drug, and this drug may cause a problem in check, make a like imbalance, so should consult his physician and change this disease. Change this drug. Okay. Other are radiotherapy, for example. If the patient is have a history of radiotherapy, usually the mucosa go for radiation mucositis, and the mucosa will still ill for more than 1 month after radiation has stopped. Should what is this in your mind? Also, we will talk about smoking. If this patient is positive in smoking or negative in smoking. Some disease or lesion may be associated with smoking, as smoker melanosis, for example. Okay, for the second paper, it's called gastro oral examination. We should talk about general apparatus. You should look to your patient if the patient is walking normally, or they have a hemiplegia, or this patient may walk on. Make a slapping on the ground. This is associated with third stage of syphilis. Also, we will look to patient face. If this face is a moon-shaped face, maybe a Cushing diseases, maybe increase in corticosteroid. Also, when we look to patient eye, if the patient have exophthalmos, this may be associated with hyperthyroidism. Also, should talk about patient nose. If is this nose is normal, maybe a saddle nose, maybe a syphilis disease. Look to the patient neck, it is normal neck, or it is this neck is very large and the edematous, that may be myxedema, decrease in cortisol level. Also should look to patient skin and patient hair. If the patient have a lesion on skin or an oral lesion only, like in melanosis, may we have a skin manifestation with oral manifestation, not oral manifestation only. We should examine TMJ carefully for this patient and see if there's a clicking here or not. When you talk about lymph node, we should examine lymph node carefully and see if it is tender, palpable or not. If it is normal, you will write not palpable, not tender. For example, squamous cell carcinoma, usually the lymph node is palpable and not tender with other manifestation of squamous cell carcinoma. Okay, fine. When we talk about this diagram here, you see, intraoral examination, we should look for lips, labial mucosa, gingiva, palate, cheek, tongue, vestibule, floor of the mouth, salivary gland, and throat and teeth. You should carefully examine all these. This diagram, this is upper lip, and this is the upper ridge, and this hard palate. And look to this, this is the dorsum of the tongue, this is the cheek, and this is the angle of the mouth here. This is a floor of the mouth here, and this a lower ridge, and this a lower lip. Okay. When we found a lesion, we should draw this lesion at this diagram and write a description for the lesion. I will give you an example. Look to this picture here. I have exophytic lesion present or arising from the cheek. So I go to check at fifth here and write exophytic nodule arising at the middle of a cheek, and I make a draw here at this cheek as in circle here represent this lesion. Answer me. What about the other lips and labial mucosa and gingiva? If they are normal, you will write no abnormality detected. You can write N capital dot D capital dot A capital dot. Okay. For the third page called about ulcerative lesion, here as you look, you will choose number, maybe it's single or multiple. You look to the lesion and choose it's single or multiple. Also recurrence, it is appear for the first time or recurrent period. If it is appear less than 2 weeks or more than 2 weeks. Also mucosa, talk about lining and decrotonize the mucosa. You should know the lining mucosa is present, it check at labial mucosa. And keratinized is usually represented by the heart palate and the attached gingiva. For the dorsum of the tongue, it's called special mucosa. And the floor of the mouth, it is represented aligning mucosa. Bardo, you should look to the ulcer, is diameter less than 1 centimeter or more than 1 centimeter. The shape of the ulcer, it is round or oval in shape, or it is irregular in shape. It may be undermined, or it may be punched out. Is this margin is rolled or have rolled and inverted? Is this represented by tissue tag? You will choose what you see. For the floor of the ulcer, maybe necrotic or maybe acidomembrane, you can remove it. Or granular, maybe bebbled in shape. Caseating, it is represented as cheese. Coagulated, it may be bloody. For the base, we usually touch the ulcer and found if it is base is hard or soft, it is move with me or not. Usually look to the surrounding tissue, if it is erythematous or normal tissue or edematous tissue. You look it if it is indurated to the underlying tissue, is this ulcer is painful or painless? After I choose all these boxes, I will make a summary by English substance. For example, patient name X have a single ulcer. This ulcer appear first time. It is less than 2 weeks. It is present on check, and it is diameter is less than 1 centimeter. It is oval in shape with pseudomembranous floor and have erythematous surrounding tissue. This is example. Okay. Right. What about differential diagnosis? Here I will write the disease I suspect. This ulcer may be abscess ulcer, maybe herbangina, maybe acute herpetic gingival stomatitis. Answer me, I usually write in differential diagnosis the lesion that may be associated or it may be close to each other. Answer me, after that I will talk about investigation requirement. It may have an investigation to reach a diagnosis. And the final here, I write a result or definite diagnosis. You should know our department usually talk about spot diagnosis. Usually we know all lesions by looking to it. If we know lesion and we shouldn't know, we shouldn't accurate about definite diagnosis, usually take a biopsy and go to the lab for examination and make a confirmation for our diagnosis. For example, this ulcer here, look at it. Number, I think it is a single ulcer and it is recurrent ulcer. This period, it is usually appear less than 2 weeks. And it is present here in labial mucosa. It is present in lining mucosa. This diameter is less than 1 centimeter. And in shape, I think it is oval in shape. I think this floor is necrotic floor. And it is mobile and soft. And surrounding tissue here, look at this. It is red, erythematous surrounding tissue. So I will write a summary here and write a differential diagnosis. Maybe abscess ulcer, it may be intraoral herpes, maybe herbangina, it may be hand, foot, and mouth disease. And a definite diagnosis is abscess ulcer. To the fourth paper, we talk about white lesion and red lesion. You should look to the lesion and see it. If it is, can be rubbed off, you can remove it without difficulty or with difficulty or with a little difficulty. You can choose. Or other lesion can't be rubbed off. Answer me. If this lesion is present unilateral or present bilateral, or it may be distributed all over the mouth, you should choose. Okay, it is appear since birth or developed recently. Also choose your box here. some lesion is disappear on stretching like lycodema, and some disease may be appear on stretching as leukoplakia. Is this lesion is associated with other disease is resident in skin? For example, like blindness may have oral lesion and skin lesion. Also, we should talk about is this lesion is white only or white and red or more red. Choose your box here. Also, we should talk about size less than 1 centimeter or more than 1 centimeter. It is appear for first time or recurrent or it is migratory. Its surface is smooth or rough or granular or corrugated. You should see is this lymph node is present or associated with it. Is this lymph node is painful or painless? If this white lesion is painless or painful, also it is very important. After that, I will take a summary for all these substances and right here. Also, I will make differential diagnosis, as I said, in ulcer and a different diagnosis. For example, I will go to this slide. This lesion appear on the check. This lesion can't be rubbed off, and it is present bilaterally, and it is present developed recently. It is more appear on stretching, and it is white, and this part here is red. It may be white and red. It is more than 1 centimeter. And it is appear for the first time. This surface is rough surface here, and it is painless lesion. So I will make a summary for all these substances. This patient name X. I have a white lesion on the cheek that can't be rubbed off. It is present bilaterally and it is developed recently. Patient have some skin lesion. And also, this lesion is white and red, and it is more than 1 centimeter with rough surface here, and there is painless in sensation. This is my summary here, and differential diagnosis. This lesion may be oral like blindness. This lesion may be leukoplakia. This lesion may be friction keratosis. I will write all of this, and for me, I may make investigation here as fasting blood glucose or hepatitis anti-HCV and HB surface antigen, hepatitis B surface antigen for detection of B or C or diabetes. A different diagnosis, this is oral lichen planus. The third paper here is called about lesion description. If the lesion you see, it is not ulcerative lesion and also it is not a white or red lesion, so as exophytic lesion, for example, you will write it at lesion description. Okay. Location, you should look to the lesion and see. This lesion may be present in the heart, palate, in the labial mucosa, and check, you write. Number, tessellatory or multiple, onset, from time, yani we say, may say 1 week, 1 month, 1 year, course, it is stable or increased or decreased, shape, it is oval, regular in shape, maybe round in shape. You choose diameter less than 1 centimeter or more than 1 centimeter. Floor or base, usually we didn't write here because floor or base it is usually associated with ulcer. Okay, for distribution, is this lesion is present in cheek only or palate only or all over the mouth? You should choose. Okay, I will make a summary from all these substances and make also a differential diagnosis again and reach a result. Usually, our lesion have a treatment. Maybe this treatment, antifungal treatment, maybe antiviral, maybe antibacterial, maybe the treatment is excisional biopsy. Answer me. For example, this lesion, location, it is present, it is exophytic lesion present at the middle of a cheek. Number, it is solitary in its number. In onset, it is stable in its size. In onset, sorry, it is appear from 1 month. Of course, it is stable in its size. Shape, it is round in shape, or nodular round in shape. Diameter, it is equal 1 centimeter. It has no floor, has no base. Distribution, it is present only in check. There's no lymph node involvement, and there's no skin lesion. I will write a summary from all these substances. Differential diagnosis for this lesion may be a fibroma, it may be a vaginal granuloma, it may be a mucosal. Here, this treatment requirement is excisional biopsy, and the different diagnosis it is a fibroma. بشكركم جدا. Thank you, fifth year, the Faculty of Dentistry, Tulsa University. And each one of you can ask assistant literature or or moderator with him for any problem you found in this chart in your section. Thank you.